I think this is the common task for all our partners, both donors and government and civil society. Now we have kind of 2.5 years where we'll still have a lot of resources from the Global Fund and from PEPFAR, during which we have to develop such models of services for people who inject drugs, which could be not only effective, but it could be efficient and would not cost a lot of resources. And one way to do it is just to look at the possibilities in healthcare reform, especially primary healthcare centers, where a lot of basic HIV services like screening tests and basic HIV care could be done if primary healthcare doctors are motivated and trained. But of course, there should still be close linkages to the civil society organizations, because these are the places where people who have problems with drug addiction go. So this is one way. Another way is just to look at the integrated care sites. It also should save money. But what we also understand that probably within this 2 or 3 years, it would still be probably impossible for the government to take up all the costs of all the critical services for IDUs. There would be still need for external donor assistance, although it might not be as intensive and as big as it is now. I think for the moment the relationships are good only because the government is not paying for the services of NGOs. I think in this transition, kind of the government should start identifying the critical resources and critical, well-identified packages of services for which they could pay for the NGOs or even private organizations, private businesses to organize services. And for this, there should be clear and understandable mechanisms, because what we have now, like social order, it's not enough, because the packages have to be not only kind of described as best practices, but also included into the state standards, and also some kind of system of licensing or accreditation should be developed for the Ministry of Health or other agencies to make sure that they are buying the services from the organizations which have capacity, which are ready, and which could provide services at the acceptable level. So, and this is the things which we hope to do together with UN agencies, with UNAIDS, and also with Ministry of Health to develop the system and to pilot it in 10 regions of Ukraine.